There we are, alchemy, remembering to record this time.
Ha. Alaska's fucking huge.
Yeah.
I can imagine.
I think Western Australia is larger though.
It's, find out. It's 1,717,854 square miles.
1.7 million square kilometers.
Or it's kilometers, I mean. I said miles.
I just woke up from a nap. Western Australia is 2.5 million square kilometers. No, it's like almost twice. No, it's not. No. But still.
Not even close.
I mean, only like a few hundred thousand square kilometers off, so you know, not bad. But in miles, it is almost a million square miles.
That's pretty large.
It is the second largest country subdivision in the world. The only one that's larger is Russia's Sakha Republic. Which, if it's a republic, surely that means it's an independent thing, but alright. I don't want to know how large it is. Size. Which is 3 million square kilometers.
So
I wonder if that's a part of Russia that China's looking to nab. Like, obviously not all of it, but some of it. Yeah. Because it's on, like, the China eastern part of Russia. Everything. It does.
Shall we get started?
Yee! Alright. Summary of what happened last time. You guys are the winners!
Yay!
You guys defeated Dwayne the Rock Barbarian. And, yep.
Does that mean his full name is just Dwayne Barbarian?
Yes.
Dwayne Barbarian.
That's his name. I have said from the beginning of these games that you guys can name NPCs, apart from like a few that I'll name. If you want his last name to be Barbarian, it's Barbarian.
Barbarian now.
You're the one who said it, so it's canon.
Yeah.
It's now canon. His name is Dwayne Barbarian. Oh, hang on. Wait, I forgot to do the transition. Let's do the transition, and then I'll do the intro.
Wow.
There we go. Such a professional streamer I am. Anyway, so yes, the final challenge of the King's Championship was a battle to either death or knockout. It seems both sides took that to simply be battle to the death. And you guys absolutely slaughtered the barbarians. It wasn't even close apart from Ezreal, the little bitch.
I'm the tank.
No, you are not.
Well, I'm the one who took the damage.
You are the one who took the damage.
He's not a tank, because, but he was tanking.
Because Avia and Saga City cannot be hit. Fucking insane. That was meant to be like a hard encounter as well, and it wasn't.
Psych.
Yeah.
You needed some legendary actions.
I gave him like he kind of had like legendary actions. He had that thing like once per round. He just go, you instantly make an attack, and one of his other barbarians could attack.
Didn't help him much though.
No, it didn't.
Considering everybody had like an counter attack to when they did attack, and it wound up them just getting their head sliced off.
No, only Arvi had that. But yeah, that's with these fucking high AC and that's fucking bullshit.
No, I had it too. Nobody just melee attacked me because I wasn't close enough.
Like, oh yeah, because of training shit.
Dodge. Oh, you hit me? Stab.
Yeah. God. No, actually, no. We have like two tanks. High AC tanks rather than high HP tanks.
Pseudo tank is what I refer to them as. Like,
as. And yeah, that's more or less it. I'm assuming everyone leveled up to level 4. For you, yes. Leveled up after defeating Dwayne the Barbarian. That's it. His middle name is The.
You don't.
The Barbarian.
That's his full name.
I remember that I leveled up and now I have a 21 AC when I use my ability.
I know. Fucking hell. Alright. Assuming we get to the encounter today, I'm going to change it on the fly. Add a few things. Just because of that.
You're our front line from now on, Andrew.
I've always been the front line. What the fuck are you talking about?
Well, I'm just saying, just I don't want you to ever forget, you know what I mean? Like, no running away.
Don't worry.
Even if you're on, like, 1 HP, suck it up and stand there.
So, the only other thing that happened at the end of last session was when you went to sleep, I think Ezreal has the Death Stone. Which really, because I need to have like a consistent name for it. I keep changing it. But yeah, the Death Stone. And Ghost Lady basically said, you killed the demon, that's good. Where did the demon come from, though? We don't know. That's bad. You guys need to find out. And that was it.
And then we went shopping.
Yeah.
We went shopping, sisters.
Oh, let's my go. God. Oh, and Michaelian, you went back to the Thieves Guild, didn't you? And did some shit there?
Yeah, I just fucked around at the Thieves Guild. Hard, yeah. You know, I was like, dang shit.
So, just for your information, because of your connection with the Thieves Guild, you'd probably actually be able to locate and basically have access to the black market of Lothport. So
yeah,
if you,
I'd imagine.
Yeah, so would I. Which means you can buy magic items.
Ah, sick.
However, I will say that the Lothport black market is probably like the most heavily limited one, because that makes sense. Which means two things. One, you can't get everything. And two, they're going to be very fucking expensive.
Get me some braces of defense.
I'm pretty sure defense only work if you're not wearing armor.
Do they?
I'm almost certain. I'm pretty sure you're wrong. Like, about everything, actually.
Yeah, I might be. But the thing is that if I wear braces of defense, that means that I'll have the same AC as if I was wearing armor. No armor.
Yep.
Okay. Fair enough.
Oh, look at that. Fucking DM with actual knowledge. Oh, yeah.
It makes sense. It's almost like you've played this game for a long time. It's crazy.
I have not played this game for a long time. That's the thing.
Well, longer than me.
Where did Roman go?
Played this game for like...
We started, okay.
At least 4 years now.
Yeah, but very intermittent 4 years. I've only properly DM'd this game and that one shot we did before. Not one shot, the Dragon Heist, that's what I meant to say. Wasn't a one shot. But yeah. So yeah, you can buy magic items.
If you do want magic items, let me know.
Oh, so you're telling them that you have access to the black market. Good to know.
I mean, I would let my homies know. I feel like I could trust these animals.
I want to get everyone together real quick and say, I need to apologize for dragging you all into this business with the rebellion. I was not quite myself at the time, and I acted rashly. I will not pursue cooperation with them any further. If
you do not wish to join.
Well, I'm just going to pretend that we're not, and you can do what you like.
I'm of the same, you know. I mean, if you ever need help, let me know, but I'm, you know, you do you. I'm not going to, like, put an active role into it or anything, but, like, you know, if you need help, I'll be there.
No, I don't plan on cooperating with them any further either.
That's, yeah, I mean, fair. Everyone's got their own things they need to do.
All right. With that settled, what y'all doing?
Well, I'm, you know, what is on the black market? That's a good question. Do we got, like, a menu?
So I will say that for now, you would only be able to find common magic items there. But you wouldn't be able to find every, or common and uncommon, but you wouldn't be able to find everything that is a common or uncommon magic item. So you basically need to tell me, like, what you'd want, and I'll tell you yay or nay.
Well, does anybody want anything from me?
I'm just going to take a quick look.
Yeah. I really wish I'd remembered to, like, say some of the shit before. There's an alchemy jug. It's very expensive, though. Like 1,000 gold. 1,000 gold.
I've already got everything I need. I say with my massive traveler's backpack.
Cool. Well, if you do need anything from the black market, you know?
Like, I have... Gotcha. I've got so many things now.
The alchemy jug can produce 2 gallons of mayonnaise a day.
2 gallons of mayonnaise
a day.
You don't even know, like, the equivalent of, like, how much a gallon is. So you don't realize how disgusting that actually is.
It's like 3 point something liters or 4 point something liters.
It's fucking horrendous.
Yes. Ignore.
Just vile.
It can also do 1 gallon of honey a day, 4 gallons of beer.
I'm sorry. It's not even close to 4. It's 7.5 liters is 2 gallons.
Yeah, I meant each. 1 gallon is like 3 point something or 4 point something. Yeah.
7.5 liters of mayonnaise.
Yeah.
I like how it can, for some reason, specifically make mayonnaise.
It's great.
Disgusting.
It can also produce 1 gallon of wine, 12 gallons of salt water, 8 gallons of fresh water, 2 gallons of vinegar, 1/2 ounce of basic poison, 8 ounces of acid, and 1 quart of oil.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Kind of oil.
It just says oil. So, DM rule, I would allow you to choose, like, cooking oil or Latin oil. Basically, I'd let you basically have any oil you want.
Motor oil.
Having unlimited Latin oil would be nice.
I love drinking motor oil.
Not 2 gallons of mayonnaise? You don't want to drink that?
No, God. Oh, my God. I would rather joke about and visually think about drinking motor oil than mayonnaise.
Yeah, no.
Like, I think I might actually rather just drink motor oil than mayonnaise. Like, that is, like... What?
I am not. I used to be all right with mayonnaise. I used to not mind it, but now I cannot stand mayonnaise.
I like mayonnaise on certain things.
Like, it has to be very light. You
know, burger, sandwich, you know, something like that. People that, like, can eat mayonnaise off the spoon, I question them.
Yeah. Ooh, bag of holding is an uncommon item. I could say you'd find that.
Holding, that sounds pretty good, actually. I'm pretty sure it's
good. Which is 1,000 gold.
Oh, don't cut that.
Yeah, but you guys can, like, pull your money.
Yeah, I already spent mine.
Yeah, but I'm saying, like, I'm going to purchase this item for them, you know, for them. And then they're going to pay me back. I'm not buying this, like, as a...
Well,
you know what I mean? Like, if somebody wants an item...
Instead of them paying you back, they pay you up front.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, they pay me and then I go get it.
Yeah. That's what I imagined would happen, but yeah.
It would work either way. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, but...
Being pedantic.
No, no,
being
my pedantic. Point is, though, is that you can pull your money.
But I don't want to use my money for them.
It's a thing for all of you, though.
No.
Okay.
If it's not for me alone, it's not for me.
Exactly. You gotta remember, I'm a Jew. I'm Greek. Don't wow. spend my money. God.
Jeez. Or Greek. Anyway, so a common magic item would cost you about 200 gold.
That's not bad.
Yeah.
Anything you want, Arvier?
Arvier.
I am really looking.
The problem yeah. is... Well, we can always just, like, go back and say, you know... I wanted this, so you guys can like look through the magic items while I carry on with the thing.
Oh,
is mayonnaise an instrument?
I might disconnect for a moment right about now.
Nope. You gonna tell us why?
He's gone.
Okay. Anyway.
It's the demon's gym.
Yeah, so you guys probably spend, like, a good chunk of a week after the King's Championship. Oh, shit. Actually, no. There's like a kind of small ceremony the day after you guys win where you're kind of taken into the throne room. The King's sitting there on the throne. And it's like a like on his little dais or whatever. But down in front of the dais is a table with some documents and some scribes and official-looking paperwork. And you guys basically need to sign a contract saying... I think I might have mentioned this at the end of last stream, but I can't remember. But you basically sign a contract saying, like, yes, we are the King's Champions. We will, you know, obey the King's, you know, word and various, you know, basically in paper... sealing yourself to the King, binding yourself to the King, and things like along lines of, you know, if we the contract also includes your pay and shit like that, and if you are like ever to try and like run away or things like that, you'll be hunted down and killed.
Okay.
Like your life is forfeit if you, you know, betray the King and shit like that. That's all part of your contract.
I think you did briefly mention that.
I think I did, yeah. But yeah, so a few days go past, and you're not given any assignments. It's probably... In fact, let me roll a die for this. It was a total of... 5 days after the King's Championship bout... that you guys are given your first assignment. Fuck, it might as well be that old guy who ran the tournament before. You are summoned to his office, which is, you know, not too far from, like, the King's personal tower and stuff like that. And, you know, and lets you guys all kind of file in and what have you. He goes, ah, excellent, you're all here. We actually have an assignment for the four of you today. And I'm going to take you to the map for this, actually. Far to the southwest of the kingdom, as it loads in, my map is loading. So, far to the southwest of the kingdom, on the western side of Glass Lake, a little bit out from it, just under the border of what used to be Arnway. I was going to ping right there. I got the wrong tool to ping.
Yes. Also, welcome back, Roman.
Hello, Roman. That little town there on the coast.
Right there, Roman.
It is a rather rich, influential town. It is the hub of trade for the western half of the continent and the the western city-states. And he points to those... cities that are on the far west next to the Red Desert. Stop pinging, for the love of God. I hate you all. No, the west of the Red Desert. these ones. Yes, well done. Yeah, so that this town is a important trade hub for those areas. However, recently there have been reports of certain merchant caravans going missing. Normally we wouldn't care too much about this, but it's been happening more and more frequently, and it started to affect some of the nobles who also are involved in trade with the city-states. So, we are sending the four of you down south to investigate and to put an end to whatever is causing these caravans to disappear. Whether that be bandits or beasts, your job is simply to kill them and free up trade. Any questions?
No. I like killing and I like freeing up trade. So I'm ready to do both.
Yeah. Do we have any contacts down there?
If you simply let yourself known to the town official, they will probably be able to give you more information.
Sounds understood.
Good. Does anybody else have any questions they would like to ask the man?
Will we get paid?
You have, as King's Champions, you have a monthly wage. That's your pay.
Okay.
If there are, as I suspect, bandits that are laywaying these caravans, you may keep whatever loot they have on them.
Fair enough.
Sounds good to me.
How about transportation? Are we getting horses?
Oh yes, this is your first mission outside the city, of course. Yes, you will be given a carriage, in fact.
Carriage.
Yes, a carriage. You are King's Champions, after all. A certain level of authority goes with the title.
Authority. I think maybe just having horses would be better.
You do also...
A carriage.
You will also...
A carriage. Sorry.
You will also be given horses. However, you have only just recently become King's Champions. We are still acquiring said horses. There will be one for each of you. But there will be certain missions where you need to travel in a less audacious manner. However, for this mission, having everyone know that you are the King's Champions might even aid your course. Although I suppose it wouldn't matter either way, for I would recommend simply taking the carriage down to the Swift Foam River and then traveling by boat the rest of the way.
Sounds good.
Understood.
Oh, and of course, with all your missions, there is a time frame put on this. Just our little way of making sure you haven't run away. For if you fail to be back within the time limit, we will assume that you have indeed fled, and we'll start hunting you down. Mm-hmm. Let's see now. He starts, like, rubbing his chin. Mm-hmm. It should take you about 4 days to get to this city here, and then maybe another day or two to get by boat to the trade city there. Give you, say, 2 days to complete the mission, another 5 to 12 days. We'll round it up and we'll give you 2 weeks.
Sounds good.
Is that enough for the four of you, or do you think you might require more time?
I'd say 2 weeks sounds good, but, like, you know, give a little wiggle room just in case we run a little late. You know, we might get some snacks, but anything past 2 weeks I think would be a little much.
It is your first mission, so I have been instructed to be a bit more lenient. 2 weeks
and 3 days.
Very well.
But I'm sure we'll be back in two weeks.
We shall see. But I will assign you 2 weeks and 3 days from tomorrow.
That's great.
You may set out when you wish. And yeah, unless you have any more questions for him, that is it.
Would I know any people that would run boats down there?
Probably not personally. Would you?
Sorry, hold on. Ran lumber from. Oh wait,
lumber.
No.
Yeah.
Like not from.
Yeah, along the Avery. Yeah. Your family ran lumber?
Oh no, that's right. It was a lumber village, but they did carpentry.
Wait, what did Travis's family do? Because I'm confused as to who did what now.
Why would you put carpets on trees?
Why wouldn't you put carpets on trees?
Thing is, people actually do that. Not carpets, but they knit shit for trees.
Carpets.
Really, that's what gets Travis. Carpentry.
My dad's actually a carpenter, so it's really funny. it's funnier than normal to me.
Okay.
Fuck. Okay. I don't even remember what my parents did. You know, protected me from not dying, probably.
Yeah. You can decide what your... Because your parents, like, properly tried to, like... Well, they both... Like, yeah. But yeah, your parents tried to disguise themselves in the village. They would have had, like, some kind of, like, business thing going.
Waterboarding?
Yeah. We were the town waterboarders.
Yeah. Jesus Christ. No.
Somebody would have it up. Yeah. Blub, motherfucker. Yeah.
Anyway.
What I was going to say, though, is Roman wasn't here when we were mentioning that I would have access to the black market, so I mean, like... You
know. Oh, yeah. So, Roman, my Kelly has access to the black market, so any common or... Well, no, not any, but if there are any...
We can buy slaves.
Yes. No. That's not the black market, though. That's just the market.
That's just your local co-op.
Yeah.
So we can buy the mystery loot boxes from strangers.
Yeah.
No.
So common or uncommon magic items.
Yeah, not all of them. Some of them, like for example, the belts up though, the boots of elvenkind you wouldn't be able to because elven shit's a bit rarer because, you know, nobody likes elves. But yeah, so basically, if there's a common or uncommon magic item that you want, ask me, and I'll tell you if it's available or not. Also, they're hella expensive. A common magic item is 200 gold, and an uncommon one is 1,000 gold.
I see.
So the blind man to his deaf son.
There's that. That out of the way, we could probably continue.
So it's probably like mid morning when you guys were kind of brought in, and kind of given that message. So, is there anything you want to do before you set off? Technically, your time period starts from tomorrow, but theoretically, you could even leave now. It's up to you.
I don't have anything particularly that I want to do. I would probably just send a letter home.
Yep.
And then continue on my way.
Ooh, what does the letter say?
Just general updates, you know, like, how's it going? We killed Dwayne the Barbarian.
Is
his middle name. He bled black, and it was strange.
Now the king's champion, by the way.
Yeah. I mean, that's that too.
King's
champion. Is there really something to report?
Do we need to worry about, like, bedrolls and tents and rations?
If you plan on staying, like, you know, out in the wilderness overnight, yeah, you'll need, like, bedrolls and all that.
Imagine that would be supplied inside of the caravan, no?
No, you guys are given... So, as you guys kind of walk up, you know, to, like, roughly where the stables and are, which, you know, the carriages are stored nearby, you can request that your carriage be brought out for you, which is harness the horses and that. It's not the largest carriage. It's only pulled by two horses, but it should be enough room for the four of you. But it's like it is simply like a comfort carriage, like nice plush seats, very kind of comfortable and cozy.
Luxury.
Yes, it's a more of a luxury kind of carriage rather than a, you know, utilitarian one. So no, they do not provide bedrolls and that for you.
I have bought a two-person tent already, so...
I'll probably buy some stuff then.
Yeah. But yeah, so as for rations, just buy, like, 5 days of rations, and then I'll never keep track of it. That sounds good.
Okay, how much are 5 days worth of rations?
Oh, yeah, fuck you.
Tell me how much to take it off.
Alright, let me find in the fucking player's handbook, you bitches.
Tent.
A little fuck rude, okay?
Yeah. I mean, am I wrong, though?
I mean
I didn't say anything, so I don't know why I'm being categorized.
Two gold. Easy.
There you go. Two gold for 5 days of rations.
No, tent. The tent was 2 gold.
I see.
I don't have 1 gold.
Right,
okay. I will buy a tent then as well.
Rations fucking backgrounds.
Yeah. 5 silver pieces. So, 5 gold for 10 days.
Wait, 5 gold for 10 days? What do you mean?
It's 5 silver pieces for 1 day, so it's 5 gold for 10 days, yeah. So, like, 2 gold... Fuck it, we'll just say spend 2 gold and you have 5 days worth of rations. I don't care. King's Champion discount.
Wow. I have 330 gold, though.
Sorry?
I have 333 gold still. Let's get it.
Yeah. So you guys have a lot of money right now.
Yeah.
Shmoney.
Yeah.
Oh, I got that shbank.
Cash money.
See, are you guys going to head out today or are you going to leave tomorrow?
Well, I mean, if they've got anything they need to do.
No.
No. During the 5 days where we weren't, I mentioned it last time briefly, but during the downtime, I'll basically be searching just in case I find any drow, but I'll just sort of like keep a note of who and where they are.
So how are you going to be looking for them?
Basically, I'll like spend time in markets and keep visiting different inns and just sort of looking for odd behavior or any signs. I mean, it's my job to find drow, so.
Yeah. Roll me an investigation check then, if you like. This is represent the entire time he's been doing this.
How's that?
Jesus fucking Christ. Oh. You know what? You probably do find a drow. In the city. Fuck, what? We'll say he's probably like we'll go to the shoemaker. A cobbler. And
works. That's a smart thing, yeah. He's looking for drow. I should look for tieflings, then.
We can get back to that later. Unless you would... Fuck yeah, just roll your investigation check if you want. I think you found one really close by. Named Darvier.
I can't find that as him.
Alright, so I'm gonna let Arvi decide this because it affects his character. With a nat 20, do you want Travis to find out that you are a tiefling?
See, the thing is, how would he find it out?
How did you find out that cobbler was a drow? Fuck if I know.
Well, the thing is that I'm in full, like, full stealth. I've got no tail. I got my ears cut and my horn shaved down. The only thing I can imagine is if he just so happened to come into my room when I was fixing up my disguise, like the makeup to cover my skin color.
But you say, you know, you're in full disguise and all that. So was the cobbler person. Skin's like completely painted and all that. He doesn't have a tail or horns to worry about.
Yeah, so it'd be sort of like body language and stuff, I guess.
Yeah, it's not. Yeah, we kind of like gloss over how you guys find out exactly. But, you know, if you don't want it, we'll say Mike Kelly finds like two other tieflings in the city. But, or he finds you. I'll let you decide.
Well, he can. I feel like he might not immediately figure out that I'm a tiefling, but he might get sort of some evidence to that fact.
Okay, we'll go with that. So, Michael, you find one person you're pretty sure is a tiefling somewhere in the city. They, what do they do? They're a messenger. They, like a courier kind of thing. That's their job.
The opportunity to possibly execute them.
Not before you have to go on this mission, when you get back. As for Arvia, what I'll say is, you walk past his room one day, and he's left his door slightly ajar, and you don't enter it or anything like that, because I don't think your character necessarily, I don't know, you're a thief, maybe you would, I don't know. Whether you go in or not, all you really see is that there is some makeup on a table or something that's been left out. Take it from that way you will. Maybe Ivy's really cares about his looks.
Who knows?
Yeah. Like some foundation and shit. Yeah.
Powdering himself. Lovely.
Hmm. We'll go with that.
Anyway, that's all I care about.
Okay. So yeah, we'll say that happened like in the days you guys were waiting for to get this mission. So you go out, you buy your rations, you buy your tent. It's probably like maybe 1 o'clock when you then leave Lothport. And I need someone to roll me a D8. Anyone, just one person.
I won't do it.
4. Okay. So you guys make it a good distance out of Lothport, but you only travel, unless you go try to travel through the night, you don't get all that far. So you're gonna travel through the night, or you're just gonna set up camp?
What do you guys want to do? I'm okay with traveling through the night.
Well, how many of us need to... Because we're traveling by carriage, which yep. I assume that we have a driver. Don't we?
Yeah, you probably would.
No, magic.
No, magic doesn't exist.
I think he was just in that case, we could probably... we'd probably have to wait for driver to sleep, actually.
Yeah, we should take the rest.
Like, the thing is that with us, we don't need to sleep the full however much, so we could cycle through and still rest while continuing to travel through the night.
See, technically you do that regardless. Just you tell the driver, get in the back, sleep. The rest of us will take over or whatever. There's probably only enough room for like three people to sleep. Like, you know, one of the benches on one side of the caravan, bench on the other side of the caravan, and then the floor of the caravan. Maybe four if you really try to squeeze in.
Well, lucky for them, I don't need to sleep but a mere four
I have
hours.
A tent. So...
What are you going to do with the tent on top of the caravan?
This is a hypothetical if they were to keep traveling through the night. No, the main problem more than any of that are the horses.
Yeah, that's true.
What about them?
Can't do that.
We have to make a stop.
Alright.
Poor horses.
Then yeah, so you camp out. So like as you guys kind of travel south of Lothport, it's a lot of kind of open grassland and fields. But when you stop, you probably stop like on the outskirts of a very small forest. Like I say small because it's small compared to the Greenwall Forest. But yeah, I mainly bring that up to highlight the fact that only like the largest, most important forests are actually bothered to be drawn on the map. It's not that there are no other forests on this continent. Which reminds me, actually, I have something for you guys. Look at you guys traveling. See, that's your carriage. Whoa, why is that playing? That sounds evil.
That's very ominous.
Combat music.
Uh-oh. Yeah, everybody roll initiative. Whoops.
They're feral horses. Your horses have rabies now.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
We gotta pull the caravan.
It's alright, you have a tiefling. He can pull it.
Yeah.
Yeah, when you come by slaves, most of the slaves would be elves or half-elves. Probably more half-elves than anything, just because of population.
I wouldn't. Do that to my own people? Come on, now.
You're not a half-elf. You're a drow.
That's still elf-like.
Visually similar, but not actually related. Not in this world.
I would still probably have sympathy. Plus, isn't Sagar City half-elf?
He's a half-elf, yes.
So I, you know, wouldn't do that.
Okay. Good to know. Anyway, yeah, so you guys... I don't know why I put you there. Actually, yeah, no. That's fine. So you guys kind of... It's up the night. You travel another full day. And you probably make it by evening to a... Like a larger town that does have an inn. If you want to stay the night there instead.
Would be nice.
Do we need to stay there?
Well, no, we don't need to. We could just camp out somewhere.
That's up to you guys. I don't care.
We're still, like, way too far away to possibly hear about, like, kidnapping. Not kidnappings. Attacks.
Yeah.
That's a point. Are people being killed or just robbed?
Killed. The Karen's like strep disappearing, is what the guy said.
I see.
So, well, I say killed. The people at Lothport assume killed, and the people at this. What is the name of this town? Like this trade town that you guys are traveling to? You need to name it.
Bummfuknoaere.
Perfect. Bummfuknoaere. So the town of Bummfuknoaere, so named because of the sphincter-esque kind of limiting. I'll take you back to the map.
It's actually pronounced Bummfuknoaere.
Bummfuknoaere.
Kind of cool because the way the Gulf and the Lake of Calcutta kind of meet is almost sphincter-esque.
Oh, Christ.
Yep, that's why it's called that. Anyway. Out of that plethora.
I mean, I'm going for more of a. There's a lot of bums to fuck.
You mean homeless people or?
Christ.
It's a variety.
Okay. Anyway, so it's
known for its exquisite bums.
It's this town here that you guys made it to by the end of your second day. Yeah, are you going to stay the is that the inn there, or are you going to like travel a little bit further and then just camp out?
What do you guys want to do?
Let's travel a little further than camp out.
Yeah, let's get as far as we can.
Okay.
Bummfuknoaere.
The driver look. No, that's not Bummfuknoaere. That's where your ultimate destination is. Where you will be staying.
Oh, great.
Yeah. The driver looks very disappointed when he finds out that no, you're not going to be staying at the nice inn that's there.
Well, he can sleep in the carriage because we've got tents.
Yeah, so I assume that's what's more or less been happening.
Yeah, I'll give him a gold piece for his efforts. I feel bad.
That's a lot of money.
Wealthy inn is only 2 gold.
Yeah, but I'm paying him a gold to sleep outside. I think, you know, that's fair.
Not outside, in the carriage.
Not in the nice inn. I also point out that 2 gold includes, like, food and shit.
Oh my god. Okay, well, that's great.
But yeah.
We're sleeping outside, and he's getting a gold piece out of it.
Maybe I think should... I'm going to start monitoring your rations now, actually. You guys need to mark off 2 rations for the previous day and this day.
Oh my god.
Yep.
Fuck you.
Thank you. Please do. Please.
Okay.
Anyway. So, you guys seem to be pushing, like, fairly hard to get there, like, fairly quickly. So I'll say you make it by the end of the third day, and there's like, probably by the time the sun sets, you make it to this little kind of crossroad here. And so you have the choice of like either staying there the night or push on just like another hour or two to make it to this large trading city.
Well, if we can get to the trading city, we can charter a boat and sleep on the boat.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, that's ideal.
So you push on like another hour or two into the night, like it's proper full on sunset has already happened. There is no sun. And yeah, you travel for another 2 hours. You make it to the city. However, no, you can't charter a boat right now because the people you need to talk to charter the boat are at home and probably asleep.
There's nobody working at this time?
There would be, like, you know, dock hands and, like, people on barges to make sure they're not robbed and, like, guarding the barges and shit like that. But no, the people you need to talk to book passage, are asleep.
Yeah, I guess not a lot of people are leaving at this point.
Yeah. What? Usually if it...
We spoke to someone on one of the barges and be like, hey... If you wake up your captain, and we leave now, we can pay you good money.
You're dressed like a priest. He looks at you and goes, yeah, alright, fuck off. And he goes,
stab him.
Do you actually?
No, I don't.
Okay.
Yeah, what if I stab him in the throat for that?
I think about it, though.
Mm.
You can tell you're thinking about it.
I forgot to mention, do we have badges or, like, paperwork or something to say that we're the king's champions?
No. But word of the king's champions, like, of you guys, was sent out to, like, major officials in all the major cities. That's why the town of Bumfuck will know who you are, like, the mayor, at least, or whatever they have there. We'll know who you are. Prime bum.
His pronouns, Shafid.
Well, in that case, I guess we need to find an inn.
Farted.
Alright. We're finding that in.
So, this is a major city. You can find inns of all kinds. You can find a squalid inn, a poor inn, a modest inn, a comfortable inn, a wealthy inn, or an aristocratic inn.
Comfy inn sounds alright.
Yep.
I don't really like aristocrats, so you know.
It's up to you guys.
I want to start a plague amongst the rich.
A plague amongst the rich. What kind of plague?
How? Just how?
A fucking rat plague.
There is a class where you can do that. I'm trying to remember. I think it's like a subclass, and I think it's a druid.
Circle of Spores?
No, not Circle of Spores. Maybe it's a ranger. It might be a ranger, actually. Where is it? Supplements.
I mean, all I gotta do is shit on a needle and poke someone.
No.
Doesn't really matter, because none of us are playing it.
Yeah. Rat King, that's what it's called.
You can... King.
I'm just curious now. I think you guys are going to a comfortable inn then. Sounds like it's the consensus.
Yeah.
In that case, it's 8 silver pieces per person.
8 silver.
Yeah.
7.
No. Roll me a persuasion check.
9. Take it or leave it.
You get the nat 1. That's what's happening.
That was a reference that I'm not sure everyone got.
Probably not.
Yeah.
Yeah, no. It's 8. It's 8 silver pieces.
Damn it.
Hmm.
You tried. I believe me.
Which ones are the silver again? The Illuminati looking?
Yeah.
SP, silver.
Silver penis.
Ranger, yeah, it's a ranger archetype. The Rat King.
The Rat King.
Yep. At third level, you can summon a swarm of rats to accompany you and defend you in combat.
That's some fucking Dishonored type shit.
Yeah.
That's a good game series.
Sponsored.
I have it tattooed on the back of my hand. I wish they would pay me. That'd be great. That'd be cool.
But instead, you're the one that paid.
Yeah. That's why not do it again. I'd do it again.
So.
Yeah.
Yeah? Anything else?
So I was reading about the Rat King. Fucking
why?
Interesting. Because it's such a fun archetype thing.
Bubonic plague.
Yay.
It actually wasn't spread by rats that very much.
It's fleas. We all know. We're not stupid. You're stupid.
I want to change my class now.
Human fleas. I want to change my class.
Anyway, so you guys, brain. Yeah, you guys, you spend the night, whatever, nobody cares. In a relatively comfortable inn, like, you know, wooden furniture, nice roaring fire, good, tasty meal, not like fancy, but, you know, like a nice kind of lamb stew or some shit like that. The good shit. And that comes with the room. You get a bowl of this lamb stew and an ale, or your drink of choice, within reason. They're not giving you wine.
Oh, come on.
You can buy it separately if you like, but they're not giving it with the room. Yeah. Anyway, so the morning dawns, and you can go down to the docks, and you can find someone to take you to Bummfuk.
Is what we will do.
Will they take me to fuck a bum?
I'll say it's like the equivalent of like a gold coin per person. to book passage.
That's not bad.
It's kind of expensive, though.
Apparently it's meant to be 1 silver piece per mile. I have no fucking idea about distances, especially in miles. So,
where are the official king champions sent on an urgent mission?
Yeah, don't we have like free travel before?
The who? You probably have to talk to like the mayor of the city or whatever to get that kind of shit.
It's not worth it. Let's just pay the money and go, people. Stop being stingy. We have like 300 gold. If you need me to pay it for you, I got you, man. Like,
as you guys like paying this barge person, your driver for your carriage kind of walks up to you and goes, what about me, sirs? What am I to do?
Should we send him home? Or have him stay here?
Yeah, have him stay here. We'll need him when we return.
I'll need lodging for the...
Hold on. We're discussing here. So, how long do you expect it to take?
Not more than a week before we're back here, right? So, I mean, 7 days. I mean, like, just give him a couple of gold and have him stay where he wants.
Yeah, give him, like, I don't know.
Yeah, give him, like, three gold. You know, if he wants to stay somewhere nice.
I'll give him 5 gold.
I'll give him 3, you give him 5. I already gave him 1 gold earlier.
Alright. So I need him to be his 9 gold worth of staying in this city. Oh, thank you, sirs. Yes, I'll... And he snaps a salute, because he knows who you guys are. I'll wait for you to return. And then he'll walk off to the carriage, and he'll go into like a cheaper inn than the one you guys stayed at last time, but yeah.
Oh, man,
why doesn't he just go
to
the local officials and be like, I am the carriage master for the champions?
Because we can't be bothered.
Yeah.
No, he can do that and stay.
The thing is, anyone could claim that if you guys aren't there with him to prove it.
And we don't want to go there.
Yeah.
That's a bother.
Man, did we give him enough gold? I kind of feel bad.
You gave him enough gold.
Okay. Alright. I mean,
we're paying him to not move.
Yeah, but I don't want him to, you know, sleep uncomfortably. Like, come on, man.
Nah, he's going to a modest inn, so not as comfortable as your comfortable inn, but, you know, he'll have food, the sheets will be clean and dry.
Iron gold, he can live absolutely fine for a week.
I mean, he could have, if he wanted, probably stayed at the comfortable inn for a week, but, you know, it always pays to earn the side of caution for such things, so he went with the modest one.
Yeah, and then he gets to keep what's ever left over, so I mean, fair for him.
That's true.
Yeah. Get some pocket money for prostitutes.
Perfect.
Too bad he's not coming to bumfuck with us, you know what I mean?
It's always a danger letting the players name things. Anyway, but the barge trip is fairly uneventful. You guys sail down the Swift Foam River until it merges with Glass Lake, which is like this massive, truly like massive lake, like larger than a city. And, you know, like the surface is like perfectly still apart from where barges are traveling across it. And you just sail down the sides of this lake forest. On your right hand side of these massive tall forests that are kind of border the edge of it, on the left these rolling green hills that kind of sweep away into the distance.
I should have bought a fishing rod.
That would have been an idea. You'd probably catch a lot of freshwater fish here.
Yeah, but I'll buy it on the way back.
Yeah, why not? You sail a bit further down, and you can't go to Calcutta this way, but no, you instead go to Bumfuck. And you arrive at the town. It's not as large as the city you just left, but it's actually fairly wealthy. There's not that much in the way of like a poorer population. Most of the people here are traders of some kind. And a lot of wealth flows through this city. It seems like there's a lot of gem cutters. Like, they seem to import a lot of like raw gems, cut them and all that, and then ship off the kind of cut stones. And jewelry makers. There are blacksmiths. There's tailors of very fine clothes. There's a lot of nice things here. And yes, there are fishing rods too.
Well, I would have fucking hoped so. They're like right next to a lake and a gulf.
So actually, that's the thing. Like, to actually get to Bumfuck, you actually, technically speaking, you leave Swiftframe River and go into the Gulf of Aidel, and then like you're basically instantly there.
Yeah.
Yeah, just to get a more visual description. And yeah, so you kind of land in this seaport, which smells heavily, as you can imagine, of rotting fish and fish guts and the way that any, you know, seaport will. It smells awful.
Reminds me of my ex.
Your ex smelled of rotting fish.
Or plus doobie dink dink.
Anyway, what do you guys do? The quality of like the buildings and that get a lot nicer as you go like uphill further into the city and away from the port. Oh fuck, I actually have a generic town that I can put you guys in.
Wowza.
Generic town.
Well, I would imagine we would go to, like, you know,
We'll need to find the mayor. Or something.
The person that we go to, like, continue the mission. That's where we would go first.
Yep. So, that's pretty easy to find. Probably, like, close to the heart of the city. Not too far away from, like, the major marketplace of the city. Town. You'll find a larger than most double-story building that very much from the outside looks like a mayor's building. It's like, you know, those Roman-style pillars at the front and looks all official-like in white stone.
They look like Roman.
Yeah, it looks exactly like a Roman. Roman is carved into these pillars.
I am Bummfuknoaere.
Yeah.
I am Bummfuknoaere.
The proud and noble trading town of Bummfuknoaere. Rich culture.
Rich culture.
We notice that there's statues and pillars all around carved in my face.
Yep.
Yep.
These are my people. My worshippers.
Yeah. Not. They look nothing like Saga City. They very specifically look like a Roman.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Bummfuckians worship Roman.
Yeah. He brought the knowledge of bumfuckery to the town.
Many moons ago.
Yeah.
And I'm not talking the moons in the sky.
I was here in biblical times.
Yeah. So
he's pulling his pants down.
Good old oral tradition.
People. Anyway.
Right.
Shall we discuss this?
Find the mayor, I suppose.
Yep. It's not that hard. You kind of walk in, there's a receptionist there, you tell them that you're the king's champion, and she'll instantly send for the mayor. Who's, wait, let me look at the map again. Let me bring up my own map. Sorry. I'm not as prepared as I would like to be, because apparently Asher didn't tell me that he wasn't able to make it this afternoon, so I was going to do prep today and then just didn't.
Yeah, blame someone else.
It is entirely Asher's fault.
I was going to be away this afternoon, so, you know.
So, rather interesting. The mayor, when he comes out to greet you, is actually a water ganassi. Actually, you probably would have noticed in the town of Bumfuck, there is, like, while there's still humans there, there's actually probably mostly Ganassi.
Oh.
Of all different kinds. But anyway, the water Ganassi, he comes out and goes, ah, the King's Champions. You'll hear about the missing caravans. Are you? Excellent, excellent. Yes, please, come right this way. We'll sit down. I'll get some refreshments and I'll tell you everything that we know. He kind of like gestures towards the side room and like opens the door and gestures you guys inside.
Okay.
Denise, can you please get us some tea? You guys drink tea, yes? Is tea all right?
Please.
You want some tea?
That's
yes.
Fine. Yeah.
Thank you.
Denise, please bring us a pot of tea and 5 cups. I keep forgetting about myself. 5 cups, please, Denise. And he kind of sits down. And it's like it's very much like a meeting room. Like there's a low table, some relatively low but very comfortable seats arranged around it, and you guys can all sit haphazardly. There doesn't seem to be much in the way of formality for this. He'll sit down with you guys. All right. Do we wait for the tea, or do you want to get straight to business?
Let's get straight
to business. Very well. You're busy people. I understand. And then he stops for a second and starts like rubbing his chin and goes, we think it started about a month ago. Various traders going into or out of the city that we... we first noticed with traders that we were expecting to arrive in the city who just didn't show up. And then it was just like one or two a week at first. And it quite quickly escalated. We soon found out that other traders that had left the city didn't arrive where they were supposed to be. And it quite quickly became obvious that something was happening. We sent out like local trackers and hunters with guard escorts. See, because we obviously assumed bandits at first. They're not unknown in the area. However, the trackers don't believe that is what we're dealing with. It appears they said the ground was torn up by something large. They're not sure exactly what, but some kind of large beast, we think, has been attacking these caravans.
Have any suspicions as to what kind of beast?
None, I'm afraid. When the trackers came across what remained of the caravans, they were, how should we say, less than eager to continue. They thought they were tracking people after all, and, you know, people are one thing. Something of this nature is quite different. I should probably explain the carnage they saw. There was a lot of blood, a few broken bodies, but not many. Most of the bodies that we expected to be there simply weren't. But there was blood all over the place, and all of the caravans were completely smashed. And,
the bodies that were left behind, how did they look?
Like they had been squished. They just crumpled, bones shattered. It didn't look like I said, at first we thought it was bandits or something, so, you know, we thought to look for like slashing or stabbing wounds and things like that, but there were none of that kind on their bodies. This was all like they'd been bludgeoned to death over and over again until they were just a reddish mass.
In the torn up earth, were there signs of claws, hooves, or footprints?
Remember, tracking is their livelihood, but they don't track things like this. They track game, like deer and things. They didn't see any fur or any hoof marks. I can tell you that much. But beyond that, that's not really their expertise, I'm afraid.
The bodies. Was there any, like, bite marks on them? Was did it look like anything had been like bitten or like brushed, chewed, possibly?
There were one of the truckies did see that the a couple of bodies had large chunks of flesh removed, but he suspects maybe scavengers ate some of the bodies a bit.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, that's it's... not conclusive enough. I was just wondering if it possibly was like, you know, mangled by something rather than crushed, you know what I mean? Like if something was chewing on it.
Or no,
flattening
is
it.
Is there a possibility don't think that so. See one of the bodies if you haven't buried them already?
We burned them. There wasn't much of them left. We thought a burning would be better than a shallow grave.
Yeah, that's probably fair.
Do you know... Can you tell me which beasts are the largest and most dangerous in this area?
The largest, most dangerous beast in the area would probably be direwolves. We have all... I say the area. The most of these attacks occurred on the road that takes travelers fairly close to the Great Wolf Forest. And as I'm sure you all know, there's all kinds of beasts and such that can come out of there. So, dire boars would also...
How have direwolf sightings been lately? Have they been normal? Less? More?
I'm afraid I'm not sure. I've been mostly preoccupied with these particular caravan attacks. I'm afraid I don't know.
Is there someone who might know?
Probably if you talk to any of the hunters in the area, they'd be able to tell you.
Alright.
How frequent are these attacks?
They have escalated a bit since they first began. It's probably 4 or 5 times a week now.
You're lucky there hasn't been a declared state of emergency.
Well, most of the victims have been relatively minor merchants. The road specifically leads towards the Red Desert. More of the affluent merchants travel that way via barge. It's quicker and therefore more profitable. However, one noble person, for whatever reason, they had sent a caravan overland, and that happened to get attacked, and that got the attention of, or rather, the noble person was affluent enough to insist that something was done about it, and I presume that is why you have been sent here.
Right. When was the last attack?
Yesterday, I believe. Or rather, we expected a particular caravan to arrive yesterday, and it didn't show up.
Where was it? Exactly.
Where was what?
The attack.
The most recent one? I told you, we assumed that the most recent one happened yesterday, because this expected caravan didn't show up. We don't 100% know if it was attacked, and if it was, we don't know where.
Well, where was it supposed to be?
Yes, it was meant to be in the city. Town.
No, I mean, where was it supposed to come from? Where would it have gone missing?
Probably on that same road that all the attacks have been occurring on. The one that goes by the Green Wolf Forest.
Fine. Any other questions, you three?
Is there a caravan leaving this town traveling that way soon?
All the time.
Should probably hop on it.
Yes, we must find one. In what direction might we find the caravan masters?
Northwest, edge of town. I wish to be the head in that direction. There are also others to the east of the town, but the ones that will take you the direction you want to go are northwest.
The hunters that you mentioned just before, do they have a lodge, a guild or something, where we can talk with them?
Not a guild, but again, you'll find a lot of them the northwest part of the city. That's most of the land game, at least, tends to be in that direction.
Right.
I'm sure if you just ask around, it's we're not a huge town here. An important and significant town, I will say. And he kind of, straightens himself up a bit. Oh, by the way, the tea probably came in at some point during your conversation. Have tea.
I will be drinking tea.
Delicious. Yes. Thank you. When you say it's delicious, like, oh, thank you. It's, our tea is imported.
I'm lifting up my mask to drink it. Just like ever so slightly.
Okay. Does, when you like, you lift up your mask, he does try and like subtly try and see under the mask, but I'm assuming you can't see much.
No. It'll be shading still, mostly. Okay.
But we import a lot of our tea from Sabia, which I believe get a lot of their tea leaves from. I think the southern continent is where they get a lot of their tea leaves.
Just down the tea in like one gulp because I drink it like coffee. And I'd imagine he would react in some shocked way.
If he does, he doesn't say anything.
But I do comment it tastes very delicious.
Thank you. We try to get the finest things here. Like I said, we're not a large town, but an important town, and we tend to be able to get such fine things.
You're doing great for yourself. Keep it up.
Thank you.
Right.
I'm sure if you simply ask around, anyone in the street will be able to quickly point you to the house of one of the hunters or similar.
Right. Well,
where we should probably head first and then probably grab a caravan out of here.
Yeah. I think we're done here. Thank you for your time.
You're welcome, and thank you for helping. I wish you great speed and success in your mission.
We'll do our best.
Thank you. All right. Well, we get going and gonna look for a hunter first.
Yeah. Like I said, it's a small town. You don't even need to roll. You can find a hunter. So, compared to, a lot of the other houses in the center of the town, this is a much more humble, shall we say, abode.
I knock on the door.
Who's there? What do you want?
Official business from the king. We're here to ask you some questions.
He opens the door. All right. What do you want? As he opens the door, you're actually dressed in hunter's garb, as you can imagine. So a lot of browns and greens and greys and leather. He does have a quiver of arrows slung across his back. He's actually holding, and he's holding a longbow in his left hand, but not in a threatening manner. And you also notice that he is a fire ganassi.
All right.
So many ganassi.
Yeah.
This place.
We're here. We're here investigating the disappearance of caravans, and we'd like to ask you some questions about the wildlife. May we come in?
I suppose. And you step back, look behind you weirdly. You enter, and it's the door opens like a relatively small kitchen, combined with a dining area thing. So there's a table in the center of the, probably four chairs around the table. The hunter takes one of the chairs for himself.
Yep. I'll just stand.
Yeah, same.
So, I've heard that the main, the top of the food chain here is supposed to be dire wolves.
Dire wolves, dire boar.
Right.
Bears aren't unknown in the area. There's not as many of them, though.
I mainly want to ask about sightings as of late. Especially dire wolves and dire boars. Have they been irregular, more or less?
He thinks for a moment, rubbing his... fire gas, yeah, like beards made of fire. We'll say they do. Rubbing's kind of fire beard and go, Now you mentioned the dire boar, if anything, have been a little bit quiet, but the dire wolves been a little bit more than though of them. Not too many more, I wouldn't think, but a little bit more.
Right. Have they been taking livestock? How far have they been pushing out of the green wall?
Not too far. If they're taking livestock, it'd be in small towns that I don't visit. They haven't been taking livestock from around this town.
Have you noticed anything like size difference? Have they been noticeably any larger or smaller than normal?
He thinks there's like No, nothing like that. They're about the same size they always are. Fucking massive. No. Fairly normal. They're usually pretty aggressive dire wolves. So if they're any more aggressive than usual, I don't think I'd even be able to tell.
Okay. What about game? Has it been harder to find?
I mean, you have your good days and your bad days. This is kind of shrugs.
Anything unusual? Any unusual influxes or anything like that? You would be like, wow, this is strange.
No, not really. Okay. Maybe a few less deer? Yeah. Deer have been a bit harder to find, but again, nothing out of the ordinary, I wouldn't think.
Alright. We're just trying to get the lay of the land here.
Actually, he stops and thinks for a second. I have... So most of the time, deer travel in packs or herds, right? You will occasionally see like a deer on its own, whether they got lost or for whatever reason. But it's fairly uncommon. Last month or so, though, I have actually seen lone deer 3 or 4 times. Which I know doesn't sound like much, but to a hunter, that is an unusually frequent amount of time to find a lone deer. Good for hunting, though. They're much easier to sneak up on when there's only one pair of eyes and ears looking out for you. So, good for me. Yeah. Ever get them. Got all 4 of you, know.
Sounds nice. Anyways, I think we're done here.
Alright. Glad I could help.
Thank you for your help, sir.
Your assistance is appreciated. And I flick him a silver coin.
So I go, oh, thank you. Thank you, sir. If you ever need my service again, don't hesitate to call me.
I'll keep that in mind. And we leave.
Yep.
All right. Off to find one of those caravans.
Again, even easier to find than the hunter. You simply go to the northwest part of the village, following the scent of horses, and you quite quickly see like an area just outside the main town, like where a lot of caravans kind of pull up. you know, waiting to be loaded with cargo or about to set off, that kind of crap.
Crap. It's one that would be about to set off in that direction that we need to go.
Yeah, that's easy enough to do if you,
Hey, somebody should try and get some money for this. Just like, hey, you need some cheap guards?
Why don't you?
Yeah, why don't
because
you
I'm not very good at convincing people of anything.
I just don't care about money enough like that.
Are you like a famous thief?
Yeah, but I like stealing things, not just, you know, earning money. It's a thrill thing, not a lucrative thing.
Okay.
I think it's better if we make it known that we're here on official business, and if we make it known that we're on official business, we shouldn't be asking for money.
Great.
Anyhow, I, find just like the nearest caravan heading out towards that path.
Yep. Did you want to roleplay it, or do you just want to go with...
No, I want to roleplay.
Okay. You see like a more well-dressed than the than like the rest of the people in amongst this caravan, or probably three or four caravans by this train, I suppose. Kind of looks up at you as you approach. Goes, what we say that a human woman, which goes, can I help you, gentlemen?
Yes, and I think we may also be able to help you. We're here on royal business. We're investigating the disappearance of caravans along the stretch of road that you're about to embark on. We would like to accompany you.
Yes, of course. I'm assuming you, all four of you are skilled fighters.
Yes, we'll be able to defend you if we are assailed.
Her face lights up. That would be wonderful. Do I have to pay you for this protection? Or is this part of your investigation?
This is official royal business, and as such, we will not be taking payment.
Her face beads up.
What's wrong with you?
Yes, I would be more than willing to help you in your investigation. Please come. We're about to leave shortly, actually. Probably in another 10, 15 minutes. I'm sure you're busy. I'll make sure we're ready as soon as possible. And you'll like turn around and start yelling at people to hurry the fuck up. Get a move on, you lazy landlubbers.
You lazy little cocksuckers.
She was a pirate in
you bumfuckers. You lazy bumfuckers.
You lazy bumfuckers. Lazy bumfuckians.
Yeah, you lazy bumfuckings. We've got an important assignment now, so hurry up, chop chop. She'll turn back to you for, is there anything else I can help you with? Are you going to be riding one of the caravans or walking along beside it?
I think we'll be switching around, taking turns on the caravan and on the ground.
So you start to think, well, if you're going to be walking along the ground, that'll slow us down slightly, just to keep pace, unless you think you can keep pace with the horses. They don't travel too far. They're pretty old and slow these days.
I'd like to slow our pace. Now, I will say this is to increase our chances of being attacked. However, we will do our utmost to defend you and your goods.
She looks worried, but like looks disappointed when you said you want to slow the pace, and then looks worried when you say to increase attacks, but otherwise doesn't really say anything.
I do understand that this may be worrying to hear, but I can assure you that we will not take the defense of you and your crew lightly.
That's good to hear. Just, you know, in the trading business, time is money. No, sorry, I shouldn't complain. You're providing protection for free. It's a small price to pay for their security. Just thank you, thank you.
I just nod at her. Well, we're ready to leave as soon as you are.
Yes, I'll see that everything is ready as soon as possible until you turn around and start organizing that shit. All of, like, probably 5 minutes later, you guys head off. I'm going to probably switch back to the map now. You start traveling northwest at a much slower pace than what they're used to.
I'll be on the ground, making sure to look around.
So you're probably, fuck, what do I want to be? I'm trying to remember, like, think of times. So you guys probably got to Bumfuck relatively early in the morning. You head out soon afterwards. I'd say it would probably be like the afternoon when you guys come across what is clearly that caravan that the mayor was mentioning that didn't show up. And it is much as he described the other one to be. The caravan has been completely smashed. In fact, it looks like it's been crushed with a massive boulder. There's a boulder just sitting in the wreckage of that caravan.
It is a burger or something.
And then, yeah, there's a lot of blood, but not any bodies.
I'm gonna run up to the front and ask if we can take a quick stop.
The lady, like, her eyes are wide. She's, like, you know, looking shocked. She turns and she goes, that should be fine. We can have a rest. My God. Are you sure you can protect us from this?
Yeah, I have learned that blood is red.
Yep. Well, there'd be a fair bit of nasty blood in there, so who knows what color that is.
All right, blood, I'm gonna go take a look. Anyone else want to come over and investigate the wreckage?
Yeah, that investigation roll was not canon. Now we're walking up to it now.
No, that was canon.
Nope. I was investigating from a distance, now I'm investigating at a closer range.
I will let you make a nature check instead.
There we go. See,
nope. Does not count. Asher, which one do you...
Count.
Why did you roll investigation and perception, Asher?
Just in case.
I'm gonna shift. Can I roll, like, survival or perception?
Yeah, you can roll perception.
Alright. Because that means I get advantage.
Yeah. So, are you gonna investigate Saga City, or is you gonna leave it to the other three?
I'll leave it to them.
Okay, so everyone apart from Travis.
My investigation's pretty dog.
Why are you doing survival? Why are you making these rolls? I don't know what they're for!
You said that we could roll survival as well, so I'm doing that.
I said Travis could.
Oh, okay.
And that was nature.
Yeah, I'll roll nature instead.
Nature. Nature. Oh. Okay. So. So with the, so with Ash's survival check, nothing really kind of comes of that. With the nature check, again, probably, not really useful for investigating this kind of thing. However, with RV's investigation and Ezreal's perception, there's a few things you see. First of all, is very quick to notice that while there are no bodies on the ground, there are also no horses anywhere either. And so Ivy starts looking for, like, horse tracks and that, but can't find any. However, he does notice drag marks of something large, like a horse, being dragged into the Greenwall Forest. Israel, with your perception, you would maybe I've done this backwards, actually. Maybe you should have noticed the drag marks. Either way, basically, Israel and Ivy find more or less the same thing of there are tracks. In fact, I was like, Ivy mostly just noticed these drag marks, but Israel, underneath these drag marks, you can actually see footprints. Big old footprints.
Can I surmise what we're looking at here?
That would probably require a nature check to figure out. I'm guessing what, like, the exact what is this thing? No, it is something big.
Big.
Yeah.
Likely humanoid.
Big water.
Big water.
Where's the... I mean, could be ogres, giants. It's difficult to tell. Could be something completely different.
I know exactly what it is.
You do?
It's large.
Yeah,
it's fun. Definitely cats.
Yeah, it
what,
is.
What's the name of the caravan leader?
You can come up with her name.
Alright, she will be Sharon.
Sharon, alright. Her name is Sharon. You'll never see her again after this session.
Sharon, we're moving.
You don't need us to follow you, do you?
No, we're not going further in. I said we're moving along. We're done here.
We're done here?
There's nothing more for us to see, so we are moving along the road again.
Why don't we follow the track? That go that way.
Do the tracks keep going?
Yes!
They're into the forest. Oh. Why don't we follow them into the forest?
Why would you assume that they just stopped at the forest?
I don't know. Honestly, I don't know.
I love this mental image on Israel, like, you know, shifty, like, basically on all fours, just about, like, really kind of looking at the ground, finding these tracks, following them up into the forest, you go, ha, these tracks lead into the forest. Alright, let's go, let's fuck off. And just leaving. We're done here. You head back to the town. It was a thing from the forest that caused this. Glad we could help.
All right.
Let's just rewind a bit.
Sharon, we're going to go into the forest. From here.
Are we in any danger of being attacked now?
Not likely. Not likely.
Likely no more danger than you would have been traveling along here in the first place.
I would say make haste as fast as you can just for your own safety, but I wouldn't be worried about actually being attacked considering this is the site of the attack. The most recent, that is, and we're going to be tracking whatever it was. More than likely, you're not going to... We'll find it more before it'll find you, more than likely.
That was the most unreassuring... cobbled up sentence I've ever heard.
I'm not trying to reassure her, just trying to get her out of the way.
You're gonna be in danger no matter what. Just by going here. No matter, even if you had been slower. We advise you to get moving now, as we will be tracking this thing into the forest. If anything, you'll be safer, since we will likely find it.
She... Are you trying to reassure her, or are you just... You don't care?
I'm trying... Honestly, I'm just trying to get her to get moving.
Yeah, you don't care. She doesn't say anything, and she'll just kind of turn around, jump onto one of the caravans, and she starts hauling ass. As much as her relatively slow caravan can go. Which isn't very fast.
Right. Okay. Let's get tracking.
Alright. So once the tracks lead into go into the forest, they're a bit harder to follow. So nature or survival checks, everyone.
Okay. Oh. Can I get a final roll of advantage from my 1 minute shift?
Sure.
Yay.
I'm the nicest DM you know. Fucking hell. The Saga City. You just... It's like in a video game when like you're tracking and the footprints light up. That's what it's like for Saga City. He's following these glowing footprints further into Witcher the forest. Yeah, Witcher Vision.
I am Altair.
That's right.
Eagle Vision.
Oh yeah. So you guys make it through, as you're kind of pushing through, you see, like these footprints, like, leading through, like, these massive tall trees. And this is the first time in this game that you've been to the Greenwald Forest. Like, I'm assuming, yeah, in fact, with your backstories, literally everyone has been here before. But this is the first time we've been in game. And these trees are fucking massive. Like, just, I don't know, fuck. It's really big, okay? I don't know how to describe it. There's really big trees. You're impressed with their size and girth. What do I hear typing? I'm worried.
It's not me.
Okay. But yeah, so like, these trees, I'm like, these massive white trees, they're probably like four people, four people wide. I'd say these trees are roughly at the base, and they just tower into the sky, impossibly high up. But the tracks are easy enough to follow that you can like start sprinting through this forest, find them if you want. In fact, that's a question actually. Are you guys going stealthily or are you going just quickly?
Quickly.
We go quickly but cautiously. We're not just gonna, sprint into this thing. But we're gonna
be moving. Not just.
Yeah,
I'm. We're not rushing.
Well, actually, it just all depends on how Saga City wants to do it, because we're all probably just following him. So.
Oh no, like SIL can follow these tracks, and so can Ivy. I'd say they're not particularly hard to find.
Oh, okay. Well we are trying to find this thing, so.
Yeah. Yeah, so you guys you're basically just running through this massive forest. You're quite like the trees start getting like more and more dense the closer you get in. So the dragging marks soon disappear, as if it was too much hassle to drag something behind whatever this thing was between these narrow trees. So they decided lifting it instead. But yeah, you start like running through these trees, but then the trees start to become a little bit more sparse, and you slowed down a bit because you guys said you were being cautious. And I take you now to this map. Yay.
Put out tokens on the bottom, I assume.
Yep, around the bottom with this like kind of gap. And you see Delta's mother.
Oh, God.
Wow. Wow. Jesus Christ.
That is just fucked. That is wrong.
Oh, is it though?
Yes.
Yeah, that's
pretty fucked up. Done.
Music's really loud.
It is pretty fucking loud.
I know you're
loud.
Not used to the, many your mom joke, Chris, but like, come on now.
Sorry?
I said, I know you can't really get, the your mom jokes don't really hit for you because you don't understand. But that was a little fucked, my friend.
Saga City, do you want to put your token down?
Why are you guys in front of me?
No.
I thought we agreed I was the front guy.
He just goes home.
Yeah, fuck, he's just carrying behind a tree then. That's fine.
He's just like watching. He's like, I'll watch you guys do it. So I'm assuming we roll for initiative.
Yeah, I'll probably move your tokens back a little bit. I imagine you wouldn't have stepped up that far into the clearing.
Oh no.
So it's like you said, either put your token down or you're hiding in this combat and you're not participating.
Do, 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 do.
So bad at the initiative.
Yeah, not there.
For God's sake.
Hold on, trying to.
Some my movie screen's there.
Fucky.
So fast, he just runs into the.
Just like,
well,
Dragon Ball disappears because he's so fast.
God damn it! Why do I keep going first?
Because you're a speedy boy.
You can delay. Oh, he didn't click on his icon.
Can I add?
You can add. Yes.
God damn it.
Doesn't matter. There we go.
You literally rolled the exact same. Amazing.
So like I said, you're first up. So you guys kind of like burst into, or not burst, you kind of like slow down as you approach this clearing. And as you do, you see this massive hill giant.
Dude, what is this with my fucking screen?
Stirring a big old, like, massive pot of just, it looks like it's water with various bits of meat in it over a fire. And the hill giant is stirring it. There's human and horse in there. I'll give you that for free.
Delicious.
Take me a little.
I am visibly disgusted.
You are visibly disgusting. Yes. As you guys kind of walk in, the hill giant will like look up and see you. I'm guessing no one speaks giant.
I do.
Yeah. I don't.
Okay, I don't. Let's see. No, Saga City does not. So it looks up to you and just goes, and it picks up a massive, like, log. That's
like his log.
He does own it. Yes, it is what. It's basically like a fallen tree that he's just picked up and is now wielding.
I think he was talking about innuendo.
I know, I ignored that. Yes.
You are envious.
You shouldn't be ignoring your players.
Okay? I do ignore my players.
I do be having my own massive logs.
So what do you do, Sagi City? You're first up.
I'm gonna walk over here.
Okay. Anything That's else? It. That's nope. Your turn? Okay. Michaelian, your turn.
I'm gonna just fire an arrow at him. Just shoot him.
Go for it. That's a hitting.
What's your range with the shot, though?
I would assume... 80. Yeah, I'd assume... Ooh, yeah, just, though. As you... Oh, the music doesn't repeat. Hang on, I need to... There we go. Yeah, so you just, like, pull back on your bow, fire, and shoot as this arrow just thuds into his massive belly. Is his response to that.
Are you sure you don't speak it? Because, like, you sound pretty good.
As the DM, I speak all the languages of this world.
Well, I mean, it's pretty close to barbarian, and Australians are barbarians, so it's not surprising.
How gay are you?
That's racist.
How gay are you?
Very.
How gay are you? Also, that question. I'm not personally interested, just curious, you know?
I'm asking for a friend.
Hypothetically, if this guy, right?
Fuck's sake.
With an Australian man,
he's definitely not gay, but like, he's been feeling kind of weird when he's around his male friends. But he's not gay.
It's not gay if you say no homo.
Okay, after that, am I allowed to move after I shoot?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, I'm just gonna move up to like right here.
All right. As
I assume a fat man cannot move that fast, so
yeah.
I don't think he can move the gap.
I will move move over here.
You need me to...
Right. That's around.
Yep. Yep.
And I will shoot him with my longbow.
Ooh, fancy longbow.
Which I bought.
That's a hitting.
Yay, boy.
As another arrow just thuds into this massive hill giant's belly.
Okay.
Yep.
Watch out for him throwing things.
Arrier.
Massive logs.
I'm going to activate my blade song ability. I'm going to move all the way up to here, and I'm going to ready an action that once he's in range, I will attack him.
So, Ivy starts dancing towards the middle of this clearing.
Hell yeah.
Fucking prancing and shaking his ass.
Yeah, basically. In that case, I'm assuming that's your entire turn.
Yes.
It is the hill giant's turn. He is going to pick up this massive pot of soup and throw it at Ezreal.
Soup.
Of course.
Yeah. There's a 24 hit. Would...
Pretty bad.
Like, why would he just waste his soup like that?
Oh, it gets better as well. 15 bludgeoning damage as this massive cauldron just lands on top of Ezreal, but the soup content spills. Saga City, can you make me a dexterity saving throw? Don't worry, Ezreal, I'm not going to be so mean as making you make this. Actually, fuck it, yeah, it makes sense. Ezreal, you can also make this dexterity saving throw.
Oh, God. At least I still had temp hit points from shifting.
You both just make it.
Oh, my.
So it's... So 3d6 halved.
Oh, my. Fucking
God. Oh, nice.
That was some good rolling. I like this hill giant. So 8 fire damage, I suppose, as this burning hot liquid goes to splash over you. You kind of jump out of the way, but it's as it hits the ground, it still splashes and bits of it land on you. So you're covered in human and horse flesh, and it burns.
I throw up. Just like straight like out from the beneath my mask. I just throw up right there.
My mouth begins to water.
Make the constitution saving throw then, Ezreal. Ten. Yeah, that's fine. I'll give you that as well. Yeah, you throw up, no other adverse effects happen to you. Saga City. It's your turn.
No, it didn't move up to me.
Nah, no need.
Oh
yeah, that.
Lost it. Yep.
We'll move over here.
Alright. Anything else?
Nope.
Okay.
Ready your tendies. I'll bust out your titty arms.
Nope, not yet.
Alright. Mike Kelly, it's your turn.
Alright, I'm just gonna fucking plink an arrow into him.
Okay.
Plink. Plink.
But that does do the hitting and the damaging. I just want to know, like, slams into, like, his shoulder.
I just start mocking him.
He stops for a second. He goes,
yeah, fuck your mom too. Bet she's just as ugly as you.
What if she's like actually really hot though?
Ezreal.
Oh well.
Yeah. Like a massive smoking hot giant.
I hot will produce something that looks like that. I am sorry.
I'm going to use Second Wind to get some healing.
Oh, yeah?
If it would roll the dice. There we go.
Not bad.
That's pretty good.
Very nice.
It's about what you lost, right?
No.
Well,
from the hot soup, yes.
Yeah, I was gonna say from the hot soup.
And then I will move up to there and make another shot with my longbow.
Why are you moving so close?
That's a hitting.
Because I am more effective up close.
You also die up close.
Yeah, well, I also die if he just keeps throwing shit at me.
It can do.
He's already thrown the thing.
So this arrow probably just, like, grazes his arm without actually sticking into him, but does cut him open. He's like,
I still got plenty of tricks up my sleeve.
He still just knows his name.
Yeah. It's hill time for some terrible insult. So you go to Arvier.
I move up and I attack.
That's a hit. That is a hitting.
Alright.
That is a hitting.
That's a hitting, baby.
You just kind of, that actually does a lot of damage. As you just kind of run up to this hill giant and you start slashing his knees. His poor knees.
Is that the only noise you can make?
What? How do you want to speak hill giant?
Different inflections. Ooh.
Hunger.
How about that?
Yeah, I mean, come on. Speak Australian. It's close enough.
Wait, can't.
Yeah, oh, I fuck you, mate.
I'm assuming that's your turn?
Oh, yeah, it's like something, I don't know.
Is that your turn, Arvier?
Arvier.
He's probably talking to Axe Knight, for fuck's sake. So, Hill Giant's turn. He's actually going to walk around, but not leave Arvier's threatened range. And he's going to swing twice at Ezreal with his massive tree. Because you've hurt him more.
Yeah, and fucking Arvier is in melee range of him and has just sliced his fucking belly open. God,
his knees.
Whatever.
Yeah, because that doesn't hurt.
Does the 12 hit you?
No.
Okay, well, it's just one. It's 21 bludgeoning damage. He just grabs this tree and just fucking, like, baseball, or more like golf style, just fucking swings at you.
Holy fuck.
Okay.
Remember that conversation we had about me being the front line? For fuck's sake.
What?
Yeah, well, doesn't fucking matter if the monsters ignore you.
The monster literally walked past you, so I mean, like, he's only used range, John, but
if you'd moved 5 feet further away from them, they would have had to have left my range and I could have slit them up.
How much health are you on, Ezreal?
12.
12, okay. Hasn't updated on my screen yet.
Initiating 15 of it.
Why didn't it get 15? Oh, because of
temporary hit points from shifting earlier, and then I healed some with my second wind.
Okay, so you more or less negated his first attack against you.
Yeah.
Nice. Good for you. Psychic City, it's your turn.
I'm gonna move over here.
Okay.
What's it?
Okay. Michaelian.
Sir. And then shoot him with an arrow.
That hits.
That. I'm being pretty consistent.
Arr. He's not hard to hit, to be fair. He's a massive hill giant. That's what he says to that. Ezreal.
Would you like another?
Right. Fine. You want to do it the hard way? Let's go, you big fucker.
I'm gonna move into melee range. I'm gonna use a point of fighting spirit to gain advantage on my attacks, and I'm just gonna toss my bow to the ground and fucking anime draw my sword across his like his knees, belly.
Rolls a nat one.
That'd be hilarious. Does have advantage, but yeah, so that does hit.
All right. And I'm gonna use my action search and fucking slash him again.
All right. Do you still have advantage?
Yep. It's on every attack the entire turn.
Hmm. Okay. Well, yeah, that hits. You do a lot of damage to this Hildon. He slaps open his knees, and then you slap open his belly. He starts clutching his belly like, arr, 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 and he starts roaring.
He must have like, right. an IQ of like 5, I'm guessing.
And,
yes, at least it's an intelligence score.
That's my turn.
Arvio.
Do you know how to make stew?
Yeah.
Stew is a very loose term. That does not hit us, I'm afraid. It's this chill giant starts thrashing about because of the pain Ezreal caused him.
One second. Just double checking that I don't have something.
You're eating halloumi? Fuck you. Where's my halloumi?
I was eating halloumi. I've eaten it all. Nope, I don't have anything. I miss.
Okay. Hill Giant. So he's swinging his great club at old Ezreal.
Yeah, of course.
16 bludgeoning damage.
Yep.
You down?
No.
No?
I'm on one hit point.
I thought you said you're on 12 God. Before.
Yeah, and then I used Fighting Spirit, which gives me 5 temporary hit points.
Okay. He was swinging again at you.
Okay.
I'm down now.
There you go.
Now he's down.
So, Ezreal basically comes running up to this giant and starts hacking and slashing at him. The giant just roars out in pain and probably a little bit of fear, and then just swings. It's like drops the tree basically on top of Ezreal, which crumples to the floor. That's the hill giant's turn.
Not bad for Ezreal, because he's not like. Not only is he getting like bad rolls against him, but the damage is just obscene.
That's just a hill giant.
Yeah. I mean, it happened with fucking Dwayne, too.
Yeah. I mean, Dwayne was trying to hit both Ezreal and Arvio, but just couldn't hit Arvio. The hill giant's targeting Ezreal because Ezreal's done the most damage to him. If Ezreal had gone down in the first strike, he would then start attacking Arvio.
And I have soaked, like, a good amount of damage now.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You're soaking a lot.
You have.
So it's helpful. It's helpful.
Mykellian, it's your turn. Oh, wait, no, sorry. I skipped over Saga City, because I wasn't paying attention. Saga City, it's your turn.
I'm going to come over here, and I'm going to shove my spear right up his tushy.
Alright.
Right up the tushy.
That's in the hill giant space. It'd be, like, one block next to it. But yeah. Go for it. Whatever. Yeah. You roll that. That's a hitting. As you run up and just stab him apparently in the ass. He just roars more. He's just roaring now. It's no longer hill giant.
Does he have clothes on?
He's like looks like a deer/horse hide just like wrapped around him.
Covering his massive giant cock.
Yep.
As it slightly dangles below it.
Sure. Whatever
so
you want.
You see, like, a little tip.
Whatever you want.
I'm
just trying to add some detail to this world, man. Come on, we're lacking.
Yeah, no, you can if you want. That's fine.
I'm going to move up and stab him with my rapier.
Alright. That's a hitting. And a stabbing. As he just roars out in pain. He looks very, very badly hurt. Like, an attack from Ezreal could probably kill him. Ezreal, it's your turn.
Yeah.
I'm a prick.
Yeah, you are.
Or if that was a nat 20, you could have come back.
Yeah.
And you could have killed him.
But it wasn't. So I didn't.
Actually, it says at the start or the end of your turn. I think it's at the start, isn't it?
So,
is it end?
No, it's at the end.
Oh, that's a shame. Never mind then.
Just about all of that stuff's at the end.
Yeah, but I swear I remember hearing, like, at the start of your turn, you make it whatever. Doesn't matter. Arvir, it's your turn.
Is that it?
Describe to me how you kill the giant.
I basically just sigh, looking at SIL's limp body, and then I jump up and stab it in the back of its neck.
That's quite the impressive jump, but sure.
I have a dexterity of 20.
That's fair. He's like anime jump and just like stab this thing in the back. It's like Attack on Titan.
I was about to say Attack on Titan.
Yeah, you Attack on Titan this hill giant. You just slash the nape of its neck open.
Oh, hey, Zap.
Zap. Yeah. Hey, Zap. Hey, thank you for raiding.
Hey.
And hello.
Gamer.
Oh, I hate when everyone says that gamer thing.
It is. Gamer.
Calling all epic gamers.
This is why I hate you. This is why SIL goes down. But wow. Yes, as you leap up and you slash open the nape of this hill giant's neck, he topples on top of SIL, crushing him ever so slightly. But you've done it. Clapping.
Yeah.
Although, actually, we need to stay in initiative because SIL's still down. Saga City, it's your turn.
Please help.
I shall give him the finest herbs and medicine.
Make a medicine check.
One moment. One moment. One moment.
This moment's taking a while. There it goes. Yep, that's enough to stable SIL.
Yay.
Still unconscious, though. Just not bleeding out.
Now you must devote yourself to me.
Yeah, it's like I said, he kind of drags you out of this massive hill giant's bulging belly.
I'm going to drag you into a bush.
No. Okay.
Oh, no!
I'm gonna hide you in the bush.
No, I thought you were about to do something else.
You guys gonna leave him in the bush, are you?
I haven't gotten there yet.
Okay.
I haven't gotten that far.
Okay. God damn it.
I'm going to start looking for treasure.
Treasure. Nothing on the hill giant. He looks like he mainly just... Unless you want, like, horse flesh.
I assume there wouldn't be on the hill giant. I'm, like, talking, like, if there's a pile of gold somewhere or something. Or a nearby cave with stuff in it.
So, alright. There's not a nearby cave. There is horse hide, if you want that. There are torn up bits of clothing. But interestingly, as you look down to where he threw the pot, you can see some gold there. As if he didn't properly remove all the clothing from the humans when he dumped them in, and some of them had gold coins amongst that shit.
Nice. Gold coins.
And unless there's like magic weapons or something in there, I'm not interested in pot loot.
No, there are no magic weapons. You can probably find like the occasional dagger or sword or something like that.
I will take the gold coins. How many are there?
There are 8 gold coins.
Well, between all of us, we get like what?
2, 4. Yeah, 2. 8 divided by 4 is 2, Travis.
2, 4, 6, 8.
Who do we appreciate? No one.
No one.
No, not your hard-working DM.
No,
where?
Man.
I appreciate how you just keep smashing Delta.
It's because he's the only one that gets into range that is easy to smash.
He keeps putting himself in prime positions to get smashed.
Yeah.
And he
to be fair, though, Ezreal did by far the most damage to that hill giant.
He also took an inordinate amount of damage that he really
should. I think it's a fair trade.
Okay, look, every single attack that hit me would also have hit you.
I was literally just thinking that. Yes, that is entirely true. You would have gone down. Actually. If it wasn't for Ezreal, you would have gone down. How much health do you have? Oh, yeah, you would have gone down like a single round of like his, just a single round of his multi attack.
Yeah, you gotta be honest.
Maybe two rounds.
He took the L for you, Arvir, so you know. He took the L for you.
Ah, well. What does that mean? Took the L?
The loss.
The loss.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay. It's a relatively new thing that us old people don't really get.
It's not a new thing, but okay.
Yeah,
I mean it's been around for a few years.
I took the L, so you could take the dub.
That's fair.
So you could took the W.
That's true.
So I'm guessing you guys head back, or do you just leave Ezreal in a bush and then just leave, or what's happening here?
Leave him in a bush.
Let's just leave him in the bush.
See, he's not dying. He'll wake up in an hour.
I will wake up in 2 hours.
Okay.
I'll put him on my back.
Sure.
Yeah, I don't think it was 2014, Chris.
I think it was. I graduated high school in 2013. So I was in uni in 2014. And I
did your fucking grandpa.
So it was either 2014 or 2015 we all started hanging out.
How old are you now, Delta? You're 19.
I am 20.
You're 20, so it's been 4 years.
Ooh, big boy.
Big boy.
Yeah, it's been only 4 years, Chris.
Yeah, but remember, it's early 2021. Delta hasn't had his birthday yet. So 2014, 2015, regardless, is about right.
2015. Wow, 2015 is
not for him. It's 15, 16.
Yeah, what 15, 16.
2015. I'm almost certain it's 2015.
Yeah, 2015.
Yes, we're all correct. We all started hanging out at all those years. We just kept leaving and coming back.
Yeah, we just kind of intermittently.
Actually, I can find out when I installed Terra, I suppose. And work.
That's true.
Yeah. But yes, I still don't know what you guys are doing.
I'm gonna. Put
oh yeah, that's how you put him on the back.
Sleeping.
Yeah.
I'm gonna put Ezreal on my back.
So that's the thing. Now that caravan's gone, it's going to be a. So you guys got here like around mid afternoon. You spent some time running through the forest. Let's go back to the map.
Well, actually, you know what? This is a nice clearing. Why don't we just camp here for the night?
You could do that.
Why don't we just set up camp, wait, and then head out in the morning. When Ezreal wakes up, he's going to be full health again, and we can all head out. That makes the most sense to me, personally. What does everyone else think?
So,
I mean, free stew.
That's true. I will slurp that up.
It is currently all over Ezreal.
You guys were given 2 weeks and 3 days to do this. You probably only spent about 4 of your allocated days.
Yeah, we really kicked ass on this one, gotta be honest.
Yeah. So, assuming that it will take you a similar amount of time to get back, you have what? 13 days. Spare.
That's okay. It's all right.
Zap, you should run a game so I can play.
Yeah, I think he's tired of DMing.
Yeah, I hate these people so much.
Yeah, we hate him too.
Yeah, I'm a terrible DM. Yeah, so if you guys choose to just camp out in that area, you can leave Ezreal in a bush.
We can leave him in a bush. No, please, I would don't set up his tent for him. Good lord, I'm not an asshole.
Wow. This character is so much nicer than your previous one.
Yes, I know that's, you know, the point.
Okay.
My last one was intentionally a prick.
Yeah, like my first character.
I mean, this guy is still a prick, but I like these people for the most part, so.
Brain working. Yeah, so as you guys kind of like sit around there in this clearing, which smells horrible, by the way, this is where a hill giant lived. You just like probably just camping it down at the other end. I'm going to remind you of something that I'm assuming that one of your characters would probably have remembered. Probably Ezreal or Arvia. But most likely Ezreal. But the lady who was part of the resistance, she mentioned something about the island of Aelin in the Gulf of
Aelin.
Yeah,
I know.
Yeah.
Ah, very much no.
Which you guys are very close to at the moment.
Yeah. But
explore that for a little bit.
You can do.
Yeah. Yeah, let's get back to town first. I need to wash off somewhere. Is there a lake or a river?
You could probably find.
I'm not gonna take part, but.
Yeah, like, the hill giant would like. He would have had to get the water from somewhere, so there'd be a nearby like stream or something. Yeah.
All right, I'm just gonna go like
all along.
Vigorously wash, like get all this fucking human soup off, and
yeah.
I'm gonna use the bar of soap that I bought.
Oh my god, it came in handy. As you wash out these chunks of human flesh from your fur.
Ooh.
Yummy.
Ooh.
Ooh.
So
yeah, I'm literally getting sick from having that on me.
Nice. It smells delicious though. Ever smelt cooked flesh? Human flesh? It smells like that.
Who would have thunk?
Yeah. So yeah, do you guys talk about anything or do anything in this clearing, or we just want to time skip to you guys getting back to this town?
Should we just beeline for town?
Yeah, I think time skip.
Should we maybe look around, make sure that there aren't any more?
I feel like they would have heard him screaming out in pain for at least, you know, 10-20 minutes and would have came running, my guess, if there were more.
Well, that took less than a minute, you guys killing the hill giant.
Yeah. Combat took, like, what?
Probably half a minute.
18 seconds?
Yeah, probably about that.
3 rounds.
We'll say, like, half a minute.
It was more than 3. Yeah, like, 30 seconds.
We'll just say 30 seconds, yeah.
Because each hill giant beat fucking Ezreal's ass, then.
Yeah.
he just bashed him into the ground, man.
Yeah.
He's just beating him like a fucking, you know those mortar and pestle things that they used to grind up spices? That was basically what he was doing to fucking Ezreal.
Yeah, pretty much. He just like fucking, he ground me into paste.
Yep.
That quick, Jesus Christ! Well, I mean, still, I think they would have heard him at least, and you know, we slept there the night and we're not pummeled to death, so I'm gonna imagine we're okay.
I have a question for you guys, though. Do we want the optional injury rule?
Yes. Let's elaborate.
Yeah, sure, why not?
So basically, when you get knocked unconscious, you need to make a Constitution saving throw, and if you fail, you roll on the injury table, and various things can come of that. You get like, you know, broken bones, like
I think the
loose eye or a limb.
Yeah,
SIL's the only person that's going to need to use it.
Yeah,
you know what? I'll make a roll right now. for now, it.
I don't know the rules myself off by heart. I don't know what the con save will be. Is it just 10? Fucking... I mean, roll.
Look it up.
Yeah, I will look it up. So roll your con save, you prick.
You guys are like a fucking old married couple sometimes.
Yeah, we're getting married. Oh, it doesn't matter.
Hell no.
You're fine.
Yeah, it doesn't. Yeah, Jesus Christ, that's a roll and a half right there. What the fuck? Too bad you couldn't roll that when you were killing the guy.
I mean, I was rolling that.
Yeah.
He just also rolled that.
You didn't need to roll one, but good roll anyway. Actually, no, you did, because he got burned by the soup.
No, this is
well, it was...
Oh, well, it's only when you get knocked down.
If you
so.
Get knocked down.
Yeah, he did not
while
need to roll.
We drop back.
I'm gonna go to the bathroom.
Alright.
Sounds good. I'm gonna grab a water bottle.
I mean, we're probably almost done for the day, but okay. Everyone just fuck off.
Mm. Well, if we're almost done for the day, I'll wait.
Yeah. Well, Travis is going to get a drink anyway, so you might as well go.
Okay.
You know what? Because it's not written down anywhere, I'll just say... I'm going to make the DC for the con save 15. Like, I was going to do it myself. The DC is going to be 15 from now on. Someone remember this. And then, yeah. And then I'll come up with a table later. Things I could grab. I'll find a table.
Hubba.
Yeah. In that case, so the next morning, you guys make your way back to the town because you're not traveling via a caravan this time. No, because you guys were walking last time. Yeah, so it'd take you just as long. So it's about midday-ish when you guys make it back to the town of Bumfuckery. I'm assuming you find the mayor straight away.
Yeah.
I'm back. Hi, back. I'm Jeremy.
You know, it's actually highly offensive to call it Bumfuckery when the name specifically states Bumfuck Town. Nowhere.
Bumfuck Town. You're right. It was Bumfuck Town. Nowhere.
No. It was Bumfuknoaere.
Yeah, Bumfuknoaere.
Yeah, Bumfun.
There
bumfuck
are actually
nowhere.
Two different names.
All right. See you, Zap.
See you, Zap. Have fun doing whatever you're doing. Was I trying to fucking struggle through what I'm doing? God damn it. Anyway.
Have you ever tried not struggling?
No, and I refuse. Life is a struggle, you see. So if I stop struggling, I die.
Is that not like the best case scenario?
It is, that is true. Anyway. So you guys are brought into like the same kind of meeting room. This time, like, you take that meeting room, tea is served, while they then go fetch the mayor, who then comes in after you've drunk all your tea, I assume. You guys drink tea and coffee way too quickly.
Tea and coffee.
I don't.
Okay, well, Arvi is still sipping his tea like a normal person, the rest of you are fucking down your tea like shots. And the mayor comes and goes, oh! You're back already. Excellent. How did it go? What's happened? Like, what's going on?
We've dispatched the threat. It seems a hill ogre had wandered down from the mountains.
A hill ogre? You mean a hill giant or an ogre?
Right. Sorry. Hill giant. It bashed me around a bit.
I can still see. You look terrible.
I'm fine. Trust me.
I'm glad to hear it.
A hill giant had wandered down from the mountains, it seems, and was preying on caravans.
I see. That does make sense.
We have slain the giant, and the road should be safe again.
Oh, that is wonderful to hear. I'm so glad. I will send a letter to Lothport immediately informing the king of what an exemplary job you have done. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
You assumed that we attacked and didn't show up. was attacked, in fact.
Yes, we kind of assumed so at this point. But thankfully now the roads will be clear and safe, thanks to you four heroes. Heroes, yep. Heroes, echoes.
Heroes.
Is there anything I can do for you? For you four, do you need accommodation in the town for the night? Do you need transport back to Lothport, or anything I can do to help?
Actually,
sorry,
Aidel.
What's the name of the island?
Your exquisite bum.
Aidel.
Your exquisite bum. No,
we're actually here on sort of a secondary objective as well. We'd like to go to the island of Aidel. If possible.
So, as you guys can probably tell, this is a very kind of energetic person. When you say Aidel, he kind of stops and, like, becomes a lot more subdued. I don't know why you want to go there, and I'm not going to ask.
You do.
I am not. No, I do not, and I'm not going to ask.
Why would you ever say that?
Yeah, why the fuck? What the hell's wrong with you?
It's like you want to be executed.
It is.
It's like you want to be executed. I can't.
He'll just hold up and go, I will assume that this is another mission from the king to investigate. However, you will not find many people willing to go to Aidel. No, I don't. There will not
Maybe
be many
you
ships.
Can.
I'm mayor. I do not own a ship myself. In a past life, I've did, but. When I became mayor, I sold all that.
Right. But you have connections.
That's not the problem here. The issue is that no captain is going to willingly take anyone to Aidel, I do not think.
Tell us who might be pliable with monetary gain.
He kind of just shrugs. I don't know. Your best bet is to simply go down to the docks and look for someone who looks as if they could use some money. I wish you luck, but there's... What have you heard about Aidel specifically?
Not much.
Okay, well...
In fact, I'd like to know what you have heard.
Well, I'll be honest, we haven't heard that much either. For the main thing is that any boat that makes landfall on Aidel, and rumors also say any boat that travels too close, although we're less certain about that. But regardless, anyone who seems to travel in the region of Aidel never comes back.
Spooky.
We may just have to buy a boat and head out there then.
Maybe. Seafaring boats are not cheap though. You must know.
We'll find a way. Anyways,
and of course,
thank you for your cooperation.
Of course. If you need transport back to Lothport, that I can certainly help with.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll return to you when we need that.
Of course. I'll start making inquiries now, so that as soon as you come back, you'll be ready to leave immediately.
That would be pleasant. We thank you for your hospitality. We'll be leaving now.
Of course. You're very busy people, clearly.
As always, tea was delicious.
Thank you.
Yes,
why
indeed.
Would you say that, though? You're going to call the king!
he'll just assume that we're on fucking royal business.
That is what he said.
Like,
yeah. But that was dangerous.
Like,
good lord.
Like, we're probably here because we've heard that there's magic going on, and we don't like magic, so we're here to stomp it out.
That is actually true. That's
probably what he thinks.
Yeah. No, he's not wrong. It probably is.
But still,
The way he said, oh, we think you know, makes it sound it's something secretive and not the thing that wouldn't be so secretive of we're trying to stamp out magic. There'd be no reason to be secretive about that.
He's the one who started out by saying, I have no idea why you'd want to go there.
Because he said this was a secondary mission. He assumed that, therefore, it was a quiet one.
Anyway,
that's what secondary mission means.
Exactly. Yeah. Quiet mission.
You see?
Yeah.
Let's head down to the port.
Yep. So yeah, feel free to roll a perception or an investigation check.
That'll be perception.
I will roll a perception as well. Oh, baby.
I'm just not gonna bother.
Yeah, there's no need. It's a nat 20. So, going off the information that the mayor gave you, who I realize we never named, but doesn't matter.
They're fucking dwarf.
Yeah, fucking dwarf, sure.
Cockendorf.
Oh, it's fucking dwarf now.
No.
The next mayor can be Cockendorf.
Okay, that's fine by me.
Yeah.
They're brothers.
In fact, this person you find can be Cockendorf.
That's perfect, yeah.
Yeah. So anyway, you travel the door. Like Fuckendorf mentioned, you think it'd be best to look for someone who's down
Mayor
on their luck.
Mayor what fuck nowhere.
You guys are the ones that name these places, not me.
Not me.
It's not Bummfuknoaere, it's Bummfuknoaere.
No, it's Mayor Fuckendorf, Mayor
Fuckendorf. How do we spell it?
It like this. Hold on.
Yeah, you type it out. Anyway, so while Delta's typing, you guys you travel around these docks, and Michael, you see a few people look down the luck on the lap, but none of them. You can just somehow tell just by looking in that none of them are really going to go. Like, they look, not only do they look down on the lock, they look highly superstitious with like charms and, you know, rock bracelets and stuff like that adorning them. So you're like, probably not them. But you find you find one person who looks down on their luck but isn't fucking covering themselves in good luck charms. A water Ganassi specifically, as I type out. Bummfuknoaere. Let me decrease that. Okay, that's just there now.
See, now what I'm thinking, seeing as it's no air, not nowhere, I'm thinking that it was named after a local baron who didn't have an air because he was too busy bum fucking instead of.
Yes.
That is true.
Yep. That's a thing.
That is canon.
Yep. That is indeed canon.
He just didn't know he was doing it wrong.
Yeah, he just had no idea. Why can these girls never get pregnant? I don't understand.
Oh, for God's sake. Anyway. You see this one disheveled ship owner in port.
Yeah, I'm going to approach him. Hello, sir.
What do you want?
Oh, God, you're loud.
What do you want? Is that better?
Yeah. I was wondering if you could take us to the island of Awin.
Awin? Oh, a cursed island that is. Oh, not. No one in their right mind would do that. No, dangerous place. Dangerous.
Five gold pieces for it.
All right, but. And he just like shoves a thing like directly in your face. It's like hunched
really
down.
Need to try to negotiate for more.
Yeah, this guy's normal. And they're like, this is like a really kind of. Old, thin, gaunt, shriveled up middle-aged man. And he's like, lunges forward, like, puts a finger in your face. But, there's something you need to do for me. Yeah.
What do you want?
You see, have you heard the tale book of the three brothers with the gift of foresight? No?
Yes.
There's rumored to be three brothers somewhere on this continent who have the power to tell the future. I want you to bring one of them to me.
That sounds like magic to me.
Yes! Nobody knows how they can do it, but it's rumored that they can.
He's we are champions of the king.
I don't know what that is.
We work for the king, and you want us to bring you magic?
Someone with the power of foresight, yes.
You're under arrest.
You don't actually have the authority to arrest people.
What? How? No. How do that's we not have the authority to arrest
people? That's not your job.
What?
You're not police. Hold on.
What was
the
he
champions of the yeah. king? We yeah. have authority over people who have the authority to arrest people.
I mean, you can, like, citizens arrest them if you really want.
For 5 seconds, I just want to get to the fucking island.
But, so he's asking you to find,
Where?
Well, you see, one of the brothers, the oldest. Nobody knows where he is. Complete mystery. He's gone.
Okay.
He fucked off. The second brother is rumored he's hiding somewhere very deep in either the Gringle Forest or the Spine. Very hard to find. Very few people have ever found him. And most of them, for his own safety, don't let people know where he is. But the third one, he kind of shoves, like, three fingers into the face of Mike Ellion, just holding up three fingers into his face. The third one!
That is annoying me in real life. Like, I'm actually getting annoyed.
He's a bit of a madman. But the third one, rumored that he was traveling down this way, somewhere in the south, but got kidnapped. What you see, there's a tribe of goblins working not far north of here, along the eastern edge of the Green Wall.
Where we need to go and what we need to get.
You need to get the man, bring him to me. Where? So you tell him my future. That's what I was getting to when your friend interrupted. So there's the goblins that are operating north of here on the eastern edge of the Green Wall Forest. And they've been doing very successful.
We don't care about how they've been doing. Give us, like, I like pull out my map and like shove it in his face. Point on the map where we need to go.
He points to like around about like here-ish.
Yeah, I don't care what these goblins are doing. You. I'm just gonna go. This guy is. I'm on my wit's end with this guy. Oh my god, I hate this character.
I love him personally. It's probably Warney though.
We're leaving.
Okay, then.
No, it's the warning. Have fun.
You want the warning, okay. The warning. You see, these goblins have been proliferating. Usually goblins, being fucking stupid, don't survive very long. But these ones, no, they're surviving. And the numbers are increasing greatly. It's got to the point where they've been able to tame wolves and ride them now. Be warned, these are no ordinary goblins. They're quite advanced, as it were. The rumor has it that they kidnapped this brother with foresight, and he's been able to help them survive better. What's what the rumors say?
Sounds great. We're gonna go there now.
Excellent. Bring the brother back to me, and I will guarantee you passage to Aidel. Yes. Toodles.
I'm gonna kill him on the island and keep tradition of the people not coming back true.
Except how are you going to get back then? You guys don't know how to pilot a boat.
He's got a boat. I will get the boat back.
Do you guys know how to sail a boat?
Yeah, I probably do. It out.
I don't. No, I don't think any of you do.
Roll for it.
No, like,
I'm from a lake village.
Yes, but you never piloted the barges that traveled along the river, and a river barge is very different to a sailing boat.
Roll for it.
How would you know?
Because
I don't know how to do that. I'm a very intelligent spy.
Maybe yes, but you've never had any reason to learn how to sail a boat. You've never left the continent.
Okay, can we just please get to the goblin camp? Can we please just go?
Well, that being said, should we end it here?
Yeah, actually, that's a good idea, because I need to get dinner. I'm fucking starving.
Yes, and because we did this session in the morning rather than the evening, I don't actually have the next bit prepared. I was going to, but I don't.
Yeah, seems like a good place to stop.
Yeah.
God, I wanted to punch that guy. Dude, that I was actually I didn't mean to snap, but that shit was getting on my not like that character.
That character. Came out of nowhere.
That was like on my pet peeves.
He is lovable. Everyone loved what's his name?
Cocksucker.
Oh, yeah, that's right, Cocksucker. Yeah, Cocksucker is a great guy. Great guy. Bit mad, bit out there. But, of course, it's only a mad person that'd be willing to take you to Aelin. What more did you expect?
That's true.
Yeah.
But I want to put an arrow into his eye.
Poor Cocksucker. What's he done to deserve that?
I debate. I think everyone else here would probably agree that he probably deserves an arrow through the eye.
No. Who thinks he deserves that?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
Delta?
Honestly, you and I'm down.
Why does everyone hate Cocksucker so much?
Roman, do you want to put an arrow through this guy's eye?
Does my vote matter at this point?
Just, you know, yeah. Unanimous vote.
Just for show.
I don't care, man. It's not my eye.
Yeah, exactly.
It's not my eye, so he's indifferent. It's not even a no, he's just indifferent.
This poor innocent man doesn't deserve this.
Let's even go further. Axonite, what do you think? Do you want to put an arrow through that guy's eye? Anybody else here that's watching?
Nobody watches this shit. Nobody.
Well, I mean, Zap raged with 5 people. Somebody's got to have sticked around.
No, they didn't. They left very quickly.
Alright. So we done?
Burn him. Why do you guys all hate that character? I personally liked him.
Very obnoxious.
Yes. The literal devil.
Wow. Boy howdy, do I have some interesting characters for you guys then?
Oh god. Oh no.
They're just all the same guy, but he keeps changing his hats.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
Fake mustache. Yeah.
He's actually God, and now he just changes the entire world so that everyone in there is just him, but with like slightly different haircuts.
Yeah, he's gonna start following the 4 of you around now.
I will just kill him. I promise you.
Oh, you kill him, but he keeps coming back.
Oh god.
Alright, I think that is a good place to end this stream. Thank you everyone for watching, and thank you for my wonderful players for playing.
Thanks for the wonderful DM, all the way up until the point where you introduced that character.
Yeah. After the stream, I was going to ask you guys a couple of questions, but okay. Give me a second.
Bye.
Say goodbye, everyone.
Bye. There goes Asher.
Bye-bye.